Okay, moving beyond cooking with food storage or extended pantry, what other books would I recommend for the homesteading prepper's kitchen? Well, how about reference books dealing with preserving what you grow and produce on your homestead? Every homestead kitchen should have at least one canning book. No matter how many times you've done something, it's still good to have a book to refresh your memory or to double-check something. You'll understand this notion better when you're over 40. And what about future generations, or maybe your neighbor who has never canned in her life? She may need to borrow your book down the line. You can't go wrong with the Ball Blue Book of Canning. It's been the standard for generations of home canners. It was first published in 1909, in fact. Wouldn't you love to see a copy of that first issue? The lightweight version retails for under $10 and has a good variety of recipes for whatever you'd want to can, from meats, vegetables, fruits, jams, jellies, pickles. This book also includes lovely pictorial layouts showing step-by-step instructions for canning beans and jams. Great if you're a visual learner. Ball's extended version of the book, The Complete Book of Home Preserving, contains over 400 recipes and includes many versions of chutneys, relishes, preserves, and salsas. It retails for under $15 from Amazon.com, but for basic canning, the standard Ball book would be my first choice. As well as canning, there are other preservation methods for the food we produce on our farmsteads. For example, smoking of meats, dehydrating fruits, or cold storage of vegetables. Unfortunately, I don't have a specific book to recommend for curing of meat. But for dehydrating, I like Mary Bell's Complete Dehydrator Cookbook, published in 1994 and retailing for under $15 at Amazon.com. The only drawback to the book that I found is that it offers no alternatives for dehydrating without a commercial electric dehydrator, and that may be something we have to consider or deal with later on. But don't worry, we'll get to such devices in another book on another video. Another preservation book I would highly recommend is Preserving Food Without Freezing or Canning, published in 1999 and written by the Gardeners and Farmers of Terre, Vivante. It sells at Amazon.com for $16.50. This book is fascinating as it details what people used to do before electricity. From the cover, traditional techniques using salt, oil, sugar, alcohol, vinegar, drying, cold storage, and lactic fermentation. After reading this book, you may decide to add extra salt, oils, and vinegars to your food storage. Just in case, some of the recipes or how-tos include string-dried apples, sauerkraut in stoneware pots, sun-dried fermented tomatoes, jams without sugar, and that's not canned using a water bath canning method either, elderberry and dandelion wines, and goat cheese preserved in oil, which, by the way, I've had from a friend who makes it, and it keeps forever just sitting on the counter. Finally, there's a great book that's been around forever. It's copyright 1979, and it's still in print. It's Root Cellaring by Mike and Nancy Bubel. It retails for just over $10 at Amazon.com. It's a comprehensive volume on the subject, with topics such as selecting produce that stores well, how best to store each vegetable, and options for root cellaring from mounds in the earth to complete walk-in rooms. There are instructions for constructing all of these structures as well, including lots of drawings, pictures, and diagrams. There's a chapter showcasing various root cellars around the country. Some of them are very old, and also a wonderful recipe section in the back to help you use up all that stored produce. I may not have my own root cellar yet, but thanks to poring over this book many times, I know exactly how I do it. There are other cookbooks I think worthy of the Homesteading Preppers Library. My personal choices are 1001 Four Ingredient Recipes by Gregg Gillespie, published in 2001. It's available for $15, although last time I checked, used copies were advertised at Amazon.com for under a dollar. As I mentioned before, I look for simplicity in any cookbook. What could be simpler than four ingredients? And right at the beginning, it lists what one should have in their pantry to make the recipes in the book. Nothing too fancy or exotic. I mean, there's a few things I wouldn't normally have on hand, but then again, it's 1,000 recipes. Next is the Make Your Own Mix cookbooks. I have two, and I like them and the recipes they offer equally. The larger of the two in the picture, Make a Mix Cookery, has been around forever. I bought my copy before I was married, and the sale price sticker that's still on it reads $1.88. Even back then, I was a bargain hunter. This book is still in print, however, and it's been revised, and it's available for just over $14 from Amazon.com. It gives you 29 master mixes at the front of the book, from a Bisquick knockoff to a hamburger mix you keep in the freezer, as well as sauce mixes and cookie mixes and all kinds of different things. And then it has the recipes which use these mixes. The mixes are made in bulk with storage instructions and shelf life given for each one. The smaller book in the picture, Mix a Meal by Deanna Bean and Lorna Shute, is basically the same. However, it offers two size options when making the mixes, so you can make a one-time amount of the mix if you want. That's nice not only when you're trying the mix out for the first time, but also would be great in the event of not having refrigeration or freezer space. This little gem is also available at Amazon.com and retails for just over $10. You can save a lot of money and time by making your own mixes, especially your own Bisquick-type mix, which is why these books make my list. Crockpot recipe books are great for those cooking with a solar oven or who have a lot of dried vegetables in their extended food pantry. The long, slow cooking method employed by a crockpot, which generally don't get above 180 degrees Fahrenheit even on the high setting, is great for both. The crockpot recipe book I like is Fix It and Forget It by Dawn Ranck and Phyllis Pellman Good. It retails for $18.50 at Amazon.com. This cookbook is jammed with recipes. There's at least three on every page arranged by category. And so far, from what I've tried, they're good. The ingredients are normal, nothing you shouldn't have already in your pantry, fridge, or cupboard. I can see why it's a national best-selling cookbook. Speaking of cooking with the sun, I really like Solar Cooking for Home and Camp by Linda Frederick Yaffe, for those of you with a solar cooker. Besides recipes, it also gives instructions for making several versions of solar cookers. The ingredients lend themselves to an extended pantry well, too. My very favorite bean dish is from this book. It's available from Amazon at a little over $10. Another specialty cookbook for those of you who heat with indoor wood stoves is American Wood Heat Cookery by Margaret Byrd Adams. It was published originally under the title of Warm and Tasty in 1981, then revised under its present name in 1984 and again published in 1998. This is a great book, but unfortunately, I believe it's out of print. The good news is you can still find it for sale used, but it's pricey. Amazon has it used for about $30. It features cooking with trivets and cast iron pots, i.e. Dutch ovens, on top of your wood stove. And the recipes, wonderful old American fare like apple pan howdy, Indian pudding, and red flannel hash. But nothing too exotic, and again, the recipes lend themselves to food storage or an everyday pantry very well. There's also quite a few recipes for wild game for the hunters out there. Finally, I just have to plug two little recipe books, Depression-Era Recipes by Patricia Wagner and Log Cabin Cooking by Barbara Swell. I've shown these two books in a previous video, so won't spend a lot of time on them, except to say they're very inexpensive, $4.50 and $1.65 used at Amazon.com last time I checked, and recipe-wise, really have some gems in them, especially if we once again have to revisit hard times, as was seen in the last Great Depression. Speaking of the Depression, I just have to say, I hope most of you have discovered Clara on YouTube. She's a delightful 90-something grandma whose channel is Great Depression Cooking. Well, she has a cookbook out now, aptly called Clara's Kitchen, Wisdom, Memories, and Recipes from the Great Depression. Check it out at Amazon. You know, I had to order it. I'll let you know when I get it, how I like it.